Okay, real quick, you can see how tall these tomato plants are. There's three right here. That's about 6 inches, each one of them. One of those might be a tomatillo. But I got another tomatillo over here. I'll show you. I'm going to make this about a 5-minute video or shorter. But this is around the corner. This is by the house where the peppers. This here, we're not sure what pepper this is yet. But it's a pepper that I planted. That long green one here. Bell pepper. Different types of peppers anyway. But here's the pepper plant that hornworm got on. I can't see with this. There's a crack on the viewfinder and it's bright out here, so it's reflecting on the screen. But look at all how it ate everything out. There's a leaf there, a partial leaf right here. But everything else has been eaten off. We killed that sucker yesterday. We saw another one over here. I broke a leaf off on it. It was eating a leaf, a smaller one. Get off the plastic. One of our little froggies. Toads. Anyway, and there's our little lizard guy. Oh, he just went off that board. Anyway, get off the plastic, Petey. That's the peppers over there. Over here's the tomatoes. Those three tomatoes I just showed you, those three plants. Anyway, here's one of the tomatillos that's coming back. There was two over here, but the wind blew these things. Look at how they're leaning over even. So they're leaning over on top of everything. The wind has been so bad out here, but the wind should be pretty much passed for the summer. This is a tomatillo that I planted out here from in the house. That's about 12 to 14 inches tall right there. That's one right here. That was one of the original two that were, one was right there. You see it broke off somewhere down there. I can't see this. There's a place down there you can see a stem broke off. But this one here. See, when the butterflies and bees are here is when the best time, because these have flowers on them. I don't know if they'll be able to pollinate and make any tomatillos. See, these are all these dead ones. I'm going to pull these all to get seeds for these. Torch sunflowers like that right there. Those are really pretty. They attract a lot. Still big butterflies out here. Get off this plastic. There's a bean plant down there. You can see insects are starting to get the leaves there. This is a purple pole bean. These have been so decimated by worms and everything. Those cut hornworms. But see, this is the one's got tomatoes all over them still. But look at the brown. Look at all the brown on there. This is from Kmart. That's a decent sized tomato right there. About the size of a small, a 12 inch softball. This is the one where my big tomatoes are coming off of. It's where I had that real giant earthworm, but I mean hookworm. See, look at this one. You can see how the leaves are all laid off here. They'll decimate an entire plant in one day. That's why we come out here and we look every day now, but this is these tomato plants here. See that one there, the third one back from Kmart, that one's dead. That ain't gonna, it's got seeds on there, there's no flowers, so. That last one's got one tomato on it. That one's got about 8 tomatoes on it, that one's got about 6 or 7 tomatoes on it. We'll get those off soon. But this one and this one from inside the house got a lot of tomatoes on them. Gotta check these now, because the wind out here, look, you see how they're bent over on an angle. That's because the wind out here is so bad, was so bad. But those three that I have on the back porch, I'm going to bring over here to the back garden. I'll probably plant one. Let's see, that's going to be a purple hull pea over there. And that's a purple hull pea right there. Okay, I might plant one of those right there. I don't know if you can see the X. This is the cantaloupe. These are coming up. This is all going to come up. These are the zucchini that are diseased and got them bugs on them. So I might plant another of those plants right here where this X is. And then another one back here. The plant right here. Again, I can't see the X. Let's see the soil right there. So that's where the three will go. Out in the open like this. Well, see, the okra is the one thing we're still really producing right now. We got those others coming up now. I keep jumping around, I know, but those are going to be brought up, those three right there in the middle, black-eyed peas, maybe that fourth one. There's all my black-eyed peas back there that look healthy, but this is getting diseased. I don't know from the insects what. The purple hull peas, I got a bunch of those off, purple hull peas. But these are the ones that had the real bad disease looking on. See that one there? Right there. Looks like a disease on it. But like I said, I got like three beans in each one. Started like doing like I did before, one in each one, which will grow. I put two and three down, and now they're kind of, I think maybe that might be part of the problem, choking up. Because there was one, two, three stations back there with two or three plants in each one too. But the ones I dropped, goofing around, not thinking they would come up. Well, guess what? They're coming up anyway. Like there's one. The last one back there is the one that doesn't look so healthy. I'm going to step on all this right back. Actually, it looks like it's coming back. Let's see, look at that. See that white spot on that one. Oh, see, the grass is growing up around it here like this. That's why I want this stuff away from the garden more. There's one. It is coming back a little bit. But see the string out back there? It's about 6 feet back from the garden. Again, I can't see on this viewfinder really well, but I think it's right there somewhere. Anyway, that's the, it's going to be there on a break, and then back here on a break, and then here all the way to the end over here. And then this one here, these sunflowers right here, they won't be crowded on top of that. They'll be back here, almost even with that post on the porch, you know, all the way down here, and then they'll break for the walkway in the middle, and the one up there. And then I'll have those torch sunflowers mixed in with them, so it'll attract butterflies and honeybees a lot more than these, but these are all dying off. Call it Fukushima, call it chemtrails, call it what you want. But, I mean, this to me, it's noticeably quicker, and all of a sudden, because all the sky was really covered the other day. And then, like I said, I got these tomato plants over here. They're holding on. They had the brown spot on them, and I broke off a lot of leaves, but look at the top part. See, it's all looking pretty fresh still. They're coming back, I believe. This one definitely is coming back. It's even had flowers on it. That one's going to die off down there. I'm going to end up taking that up. I believe that's an eggplant, and that's an eggplant up there. Right there. Pepper. Believe it or not, tomato, which are hanging on. They're green, but they're not, it's not producing anything, not getting any bigger. I believe this is a pepper. That was a bean. That's gone. Here's my other. It looked like peas. These look like sweet peas rather than beans. These two here. And that over there is a bean. And the squash has got bugs on them. The squash is going to be one of the things I'm doubting about replanting next year. So that's it, Joe. You'll have that kind of look, that mix, all the way over there and around the back and even on this side over here. It'll be the sunflowers and those orange torch sunflowers. More butterflies, more honeybees. So, but if we do anything, we're going to put two cucumber plants up here and maybe, I mean, I said five before, but I might be just doing three zucchini. I might do two black beauties and one golden zucchini, and that's it up here. And then the tomatoes will be moved closer to that section over there. No more pumpkin. The okra might be over here where those tomatoes are, and right in this area. I have two rows here and two rows over there. And this is shorter, so we won't have as many. We got like 28 over there now. We might have like 16 next year. Okay, because we had a lot, like I said, but it just overwhelmed and got a lot of, then the disease, the chemtrails, and the Fukushima, because again, I don't know if that's normal for the first week in August for sunflowers to be looking like that already. Yeah, okra's still producing big time, so got that, and the tomatoes, and the beans over there that are coming up. These beans hopefully will keep coming up.